Hi there, thank you so much for joining me today. This video is going to be my halfway update for my 10 by spring project pan. I'm excited to share my progress. I did very well, if I do say so myself. I think I have really great progress on each product to show you, so let's just get started. First one I want to talk about is the Milani Make It Last 16 Hour Wear Setting Spray. I was right between the words make it and last. Right at the top, I had about 2/3 of the product left. I am now down to the bottom, right where it says 16 hour wear. I don't have a lot left. This is something that I can easily see myself finishing by the end of the project. It's only 2 ounces, so I did expect to go through it very quickly. It has a very fine mist, but it is heavily scented. Also, I don't think it's the best at making my makeup last all day. However, it is something that gives me a little bit more of a glow. It takes down the powdery look, so this is a fantastic time of the year to be wearing something like this. So yeah, I have no doubt that this will be gone by the end of the project. The next product is the Becca First Light Priming Filter. It's the purple version. At the beginning of this project, I was right above the word first on First Light Priming Filter, and now I am just at the A in Becca. So I've made some decent progress. I think if I use this a lot more regularly, I definitely can have this done by the end of the project. I think I was maybe being a little bit too cocky about it, so I was playing with other primers at the same time and not giving this my full focus, so I will be sure to do that. And I'm still very optimistic that this will be finished by the end of the project. The next one I was really surprised about is the Ulta Beauty Juice Infused Lip Oil. It's the cranberry and pomegranate version. And at the time, I still had a lot of product left. I was right at the, wherever it says juice on the tube, I was right above the U in juice. And I had a lot of product left. I'm not one to go through lip products very quickly, but this is a great moisturizing product. I can use it in the morning while I'm putting makeup on. I can put it on really easily throughout the day at the office. And it's something that I really grew to enjoy using. It's kind of like a lip gloss. It's not oily or greasy. It's got a sticky feeling to it. It's moisturizing. It stays around for a while. I now am just at the T in Ulta Beauty. I think the stopper uses up a lot of space within this little portion here. So this I definitely can see myself finishing even within the next couple of weeks. The next one I'm a little bit disappointed in, it's the Milani Supreme Kohl Kajal Eyeliner. This is a really nice pencil liner that stays in the waterline on the upper lash line, and it's very black. It's very blendable whenever you put it on, but then when it sets, it stays put. It's affordable. I really do enjoy this eyeliner. I had a little bit left, and whenever I was pulling it up to check my progress, the little tiny bit that I had left ended up falling off and like onto the ground somewhere. I didn't want to salvage it. I didn't think there was a sanitary way I could do that. And so I'm going to consider it done. I have also since then finished another eyeliner pencil from LA Girl. I only had a little bit left, and that is done too. So I've technically finished 2 eyeliners within the duration of this project pan. There are some other eyeliner pencils I want to try in the meantime. I think I'm going to try the Marc Jacobs highliners and see if those are worth the hype, because I always hear about them being really good about staying in the waterline, and that's really what I want in an eyeliner pencil. So this was great. We had a good run. I was so close to finishing it, so I'm going to consider it done. I'm going to consider it a success. Next product here is from Tarte. It's the Mini Blush in the shade Paaarty. And I had repressed it and only had a little bit of product left in the pan in the introduction of this project. And since then, I have hit pan on the product again, and I really don't have that much left. I use this every day. I think it's a great neutral everyday blush. I'm wearing it today, and I can definitely see myself finishing this by the time spring comes. Next one is the Becca Moonstone Highlighter. It's just a little mini version. At the beginning of this project, I had hit some pretty significant pan, and I have since expanded the pan quite a bit. I think after I film this video, after I finish filming, I'm going to repress this, and that way it's back in the center of the pan. It'll be a little bit easier to reach with my brush. I find that once the product gets to those outer corners of the pan, it's much harder to get an even coat on your brush, and just harder to get the product out in general, and I feel like I'm damaging my brushes and just working too hard to get some highlighter on my face. So I am going to repress this, and hopefully it'll be done by the end of the project. It's a soft formula as it is. I imagine it'll repress well. I've heard other people, whenever they repress these powders, they say they repress pretty well, so I feel like it'll be all right, and then most likely we'll have it finished by the end of the project. The next product, I'm not entirely sure if you're going to be able to see my progress in photos. It's the Kevyn Aucoin Sculpting Powder in the shade Light, and I have been using this very regularly and really enjoying it. I'm wearing it today. I wear it right underneath my cheekbones. I use it under my jawline a little bit. Sometimes I use it as a crease shade or a brow powder. Sometimes I will put it right under my lip to make it look a little bit poutier. I think that's like a Kardashian beauty trick, I believe. Sometimes I'll put it right on my temples as well. It's just a really great, like, universal product. I use an incredibly light hand, and I have found the perfect brush to use. Let me show you. It's this one right here. It's the e.l.f. Blending Brush. It's a smaller brush. It's a fan-shaped brush, but it's very thick, and it's not too dense. And so I just very gently tap in here, tap off the excess, or kind of rub it on the back of my wrist, and then I kind of, like, stamp a tiny bit, like, very lightly right here. And then once I feel like I've put down enough product, I'll put maybe the rest over on this side, and then I will blend upward in circles. And I'll do that on my chin. I'll sometimes do it like right around my eyes if I'm feeling a little bit sloppy and not too concerned about like having really precise crease work. I do it sometimes on the side of my nose, like I said, on my temples. I just think this is the perfect brush for me for this because it keeps me from putting on too much and looking like I have a stripe of dirt on my face. I think the lights are a little bit too bright, but I'm hoping you guys can see that. There is a definite significant dip in the center. I'm guessing if I continue to use it regularly, I might either hit pan or come very, very close to hitting pan. Beautiful product. I'm very pleasantly surprised with this. This is way easier to use than the cream contour stick from Anastasia Beverly Hills that I had in a project pan in the past. This is way easier to use. It's a lighter shade. It's very soft and blendable, so it's not so pigmented that it's like way too much right on the first application. Really nice product. I'm pleasantly surprised. I've had this for a while, and it's just one of those products that I forget to include in my makeup routine, and now that I've brought it in, it's a very easy step for me to add. The next product is from NYX. It's the Slide-On Glide-On Lip Liner in the shade Sugar Glass. I have used this regularly, more regularly than I normally do, all over my lips, sometimes just as a lip liner. And even though I've been reaching for it more, and I do think I've made good progress in the past month, I feel like if I just step it up and use it just maybe one or two more days a week, I really feel like I can have this done. In my experience with using up other pencils from this line, I feel like once I get down to maybe another inch and a half, 2 inches, once I get down that far, it'll stop sharpening. Something else will be in the place of where the product is, like maybe like more plastic or something, and it just won't sharpen anymore and it'll be finished. So I don't think I have this much product left. I think I only have like maybe another inch and a half. So I really feel good about still being able to finish this by the end of the project. And the very last one I'm excited about, but also kind of bummed out about, it's the Urban Decay Ozone Primer Pencil. I use this on my eyelids. Sometimes when I remember, I also use it underneath my eyes as well as like an under eye primer. And I do enjoy this. I use it about 4 to 5 times before I have to sharpen it again because it is a softer formula and very easily spreadable. So I feel like it shows progress every single time I use it. But this is an $18 pencil, and I do think it performs well, and it is a good primer, but I'm blowing through this. You figure I do have to sharpen it every 4 or 5 days, and I just feel like this is going so fast, like I'm just sharpening away my money. And I feel that way with a lot of sharpenable products, so I am counting how many times I'm using this. I'll discuss this in a future how long does it take to use up makeup video, but for now, in my head, I'm thinking getting one of these primer potions from Urban Decay. I feel like you get way more uses out of this than you do the pencil. This is more expensive, but I think if you were to compare the cost divided by the number of uses, I still feel like this would give you a better value. I can't say that for sure because I haven't finished either of these. I'm tracking my uses of both of them, so I will be talking about them in the future in general. But I don't know, I just feel like this is a better value for your money than this. And I'm kind of sad that I'm going through it so quickly considering I paid $18 for it. I finished filming and I realized I forgot to talk about the Ulta Lip Primer. Whenever I was measuring it on the cards and marking my progress, I absentmindedly just put it back in my drawer and forgot. Luckily, I remembered just before I put everything away. So this one, it falls out of the tube, and so I have to be extra careful when I do use it. I only roll it up a little bit so that just enough product is out ready for me to use. I definitely will have this done by the end of the project. I really just wanted to finish this before it expires. I think it's a good product and it smells really good. It smells sweet like vanilla. I have no doubt that this will be done by the end of the project, and I just kind of use it once in the morning whenever I'm getting ready. I might bring it with me and reapply after lunch at work before I put on another lip, but yeah, I don't feel like I need to rush to use this up. I think if I just use it once a day, it'll be gone by the end of the project. And those are all of the products I have to talk about today. I feel good about the progress I've made on each product. I don't think I'm overusing anything. I feel like if I really want to finish that lip liner, I'm gonna have to step it up, but I feel like I'm up to the challenge. It's a really nice nude brown shade, so I feel like I can incorporate it into most looks. It's something I can easily wear to work. It's a comfortable formula that lasts a long time. In general, there's no product in there that I don't feel like I can hit my goal on by the end of the project, so stay tuned for my finale. It'll be either on March 20th or the day before. That's officially when spring starts in the US. But in the meantime, that's everything I have. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys!